Moemedi, thanks so much for your time. Just looking at the six priority areas for your government that you have just given to me, I can't help but notice that, I mean, the agenda or the point that speaks most to turning this economy around, being, you know, develop new industries, create jobs and employ our youth, is number four on your priority. Looking at where the economy is right now, one would think it should be number one and not the fact that you want to build black power and restore people's human dignity. Can you tell us why the economy is so low down on the agenda, or is that not the case?
Well, at least the economy is a priority for AZAPO, even if it is number four. But where we start, we believe that, you know, building a society founded on human dignity is also very crucial, and that's why black power and restoring our people's dignity has become the number one issue, because you can grow an economy, but if you don't distribute the wealth in the economy, if you don't reduce inequality, if you don't ensure that the benefits of prosperity are shared by all, then that economy is just as bad as any other economy. So it's important that we make the social also very central, the political also very central to economic issues. So that's why, you know, you have those issues being ranked like that. And certainly we take the economy very seriously. That's why we've made it a priority issue.
All right. You know, we're going to get deeper into this conversation, but we have been going out and speaking with South Africans about what they actually want, what their challenges are within this economy, what they want political parties like you to deliver for them. Let's hear one of those voices.
Okay, my issue is that the government's focus for equality in general has been a bit misguided, and that they have obviously tried to address the issue of apartheid and, you know, all that. But I feel that they need to address the fact that we're all in the same boat.
My biggest issue is the fact that a lot of young people don't have jobs, and that's my biggest concern. That's the only thing that worries me the most, and I wish the government could just come up with a plan of creating jobs, you know, so that all these people, Kokasi, would get employment.
My biggest issue is unemployment.
Well, there you go. And actually, one of those clips is speaking to what you're talking about in terms of restoring the human dignity. I mean, the lady from the township referring to it informally as a Kokasi, really speaking to what her issue is. But Moemedi, I want to speak with you about the comparisons that people have made between your party and essentially the EFF. Okay. The comparisons arise because many see the similarities, very close similarities between the two, except the EFF has just been described as a younger and a fresher version of AZAPO. Oh, do you agree?
No, I don't think we agree with that. I think AZAPO is a party that has been around for 50 years. It has got a political culture. It has got a distinct ideology. And it has a very distinct message to what the EFF is propagating. I will concede that there are certain elements where, you know, our messages complement each other. And that is not a bad thing.
Sure.
I mean, we're quite happy that they are also mainstreaming into the issue of the land, which is something that AZAPO has campaigned on for over 50 years during the liberation struggle, and now under conditions of democracy. But, you know, where we differ on the issue of the land, the EFF speaks about expropriation, which presupposes that those who have the land now own it justifiably and legally. And we don't agree with the EFF on that. So where we stand on the issue of the land, we're saying that the land must be repossessed. The state must nationalize the land and redistribute the land equitably amongst all those who live in this country, amongst all those who need it.
And can you see the potential sort of backlash from your investment community to that? And how would you deal with that? Because, I mean, backlash from them essentially throws water on all of your plans presented here.
I think sensible investors will know that there is no way in which you can operate in an economy which is politically unstable. And the source of instability will be caused by the iniquitous blend distribution patterns. So if we have investors that are sensible, that take themselves seriously, and even farmers who currently own the land, they will know that it is in their interest to come up with viable proposals on how to address this issue of the land. There is no way in which, you know, the majority in this country will still be reduced to only owning about 13% of the land. That is economically not prosperous. That is politically unstable. And as AZAPO, what we are saying is, we've got to repossess the land, and we've got to redistribute it equitably. And we are calling upon organizations like AgriSA, Solidaritate, and all of those who are speaking for white farmers and who are advocating for the retention of the existing land patterns to say, think again.
All right.
Come up with viable solutions so that we can all live in a South Africa that is prosperous and that is politically stable.
All right. I mean, to be fair to you, land ranks around number four, number five of the priorities of many of the people that we've been speaking to.
Okay.
Going into this election. I mean, the main thing is about jobs. It's about jobs, jobs, jobs. Mm-hmm. What's your plan for job creation, and especially for the biggest demographic right now in the country, and the biggest demographic potentially going into this election being young people?
If you look at our manifesto and the priority issues, we do put emphasis on developing new industries. Since 1994, we haven't really created any new industries in South Africa along the lines of your East Coast, you know, big industries in manufacturing that can absorb the army of unemployed people that we have. And AZAPO says that we need a big plan that will focus on mass employment absorption. So creating new industries becomes very key, which means that we have to realign the mandates and the focus of our development finance institutions,
sure,
our investment community in this country, which we believe is not doing enough to put money into building new industries, which also means that we have to make sure that our policies, the incentives, the grants systems that we have in government and in many of the DFIs are aligned to that mandate. We are also saying that let's focus on labor-intensive sectors. If you look at where the focus has been in South Africa over the last 24 years, we've put a lot of money in capital-intensive sectors, which have not given us the correct job outcomes. And as AZAPO is saying, we need a review.
Sure.
Let's put money into primary agriculture. Let's put money into light industrial manufacturing. Let's put money into community industries, because that's where you can create the jobs on a massive scale.
Okay, let's just leave it there. Let's leave it there for now. Let's hear more from what South Africans are wanting and expecting from political parties.
I was so excited. I was so happy. I thought that for the first time in my life, I'm going to have a say in the running of the government. Whatever I'm going to talk is going to be taken into consideration. These people that you are going to elect is like hiring someone to work for you. I felt like a boss the first time in my life, that whoever is working is going to work for me. It's going to take orders. It's going to listen to me. It's going to make my life better than before. But it hasn't gone that way. It has gone horribly wrong. It's like driving a car and all of a sudden two wheels just go out at the same time. That is a freak accident that we find ourselves today with a government that doesn't know whether they're going or they're coming, with the people that thinks that they can just act with impunity. No one can touch them. No one can. People can just take money and no one can be arrested. It's commission after commission. How much are they spending on those commissions instead of just taking the law enforcement to do the job?
Oh, well, there you have it, hearing from a South African, I think, representing the voice of many who were promised a lot,
yeah,
but are disappointed because many of that wasn't achieved. What do you make of what he said?
I absolutely agree with what he's saying. We cannot run a governance system that is based on impunity in instances of wrongdoing. If we don't correct that, our country is going to go down the tube. And we are calling upon South Africans to say, we've got to bring back lawlessness. We've got to ensure that those who are corrupt, those who steal from the people, are arrested, mm-hmm, and they are charged, because that's the only way we are going to arrest the scourge. But if political parties continue to provide cover for such people, if political parties do not discipline their members who engage in criminal and corrupt activities, then this country is certainly going to disintegrate. And that's why AZAPO is coming in, and it is saying that we have to put values in the center of our governance system. And in that sense, we do agree with the concern that he shares. And we do believe that AZAPO has got very capable, professional, and people of high moral standing who we can deploy in government to help with our governance system.
Okay, so talking the numbers now, zero seats won in the National Assembly in 2014.
Yeah.
What is your expectation for 2019?
Well, we've received positive feedback, both from our supporters and our detractors. They are saying that we can notice and we can see the campaign of AZAPO, but we also like particularly the policies that AZAPO is advancing and the message that we are getting from your organization, and many of them are saying that they are hopeful that AZAPO will get a number of seats.
How many is a number?
Well, I don't want to to talk absolutes now.
Right.
But there's confidence.
More than zero.
That more than zero, definitely.
All right.
The graph is going up. That's the message that we want to share with the electorate.
Moemedi, best of luck to you and the AZAPO political party.